Hello dear students, good morning to all of you. Today we will understand a new topic of Indian economic development named a comparative study of India, Pakistan and China. Now let us understand the comparative study of India and Pakistan very first. Growth strategy of India and Pakistan. After independence, India and Pakistan adopted a similar strategy of growth. The principal features of the strategy are: first, it was a mixed economy model of growth. In this, the key role was given to the public sector and the secondary role was given to the private sector. Both the countries relied on public sector as the core sector of the economy. Both the countries relied basically on inward-looking strategy of growth. Over time, the strategy of growth has undergone a significant change in India and Pakistan. Now, if we talk about the change, now the government in both the economies relying on both public sector and private sector, but greater importance is given to private sector rather than public sector. Now it provides greater importance to FDI, foreign direct investment, rather than the domestic investment. Now let us talk the comparative performance of the economies of India and Pakistan. If you talk about the comparative performance, it can be explained through different parameters. The first one, GDP growth. Now let us understand the growth story of India. In 2019, GDP of India was estimated to be $2.972 trillion. Between 1951 to 2019, Indian economy achieved an average annual growth rate of 6%. The GDP growth in India showed a substantial rise only after 1991. There are some basic factors: a massive shift towards privatization, a transformation toward liberalization, greater reliance on export promotion, foreign direct investment was the main source of investment. GDP growth rate in India has increased due to new economic policy. However, since 2014, employment opportunities have been reduced. Growth without employment is becoming an emerging challenge of the economy in India. Now, if we talk about the word growth without employment, means GDP of the country is increasing day by day, but employment opportunities are not increasing. It means the country is growing, there's a growth, but no employment. This situation arises maybe due to more use of capital rather than the use of labor. So if we talk about that, when a country is growing and there is a growth, production is increasing, but employment opportunities are not increasing, it shows growth without employment. Now let us talk about the growth strategy or growth story of Pakistan. In 2019, GDP of Pakistan was estimated to be $274.05 billion. Pakistan's economy achieved an average annual growth rate of 4.2% between 1960 and 2019. Economic reforms in Pakistan were almost similar to those of India, but from the beginning of 2008, domestic investment as well as foreign direct investment started shrinking. GDP growth rate of Pakistan was 5.3% in 2017. GDP growth rate of Pakistan was very slow, which led to low level of income. Pakistan economy trapped into a low income, low growth economy. If we talk about the conclusion, then India performed better than Pakistan with regard to GDP growth. Now let us understand the structure of growth. Now look at the table given to you. The growth process caused a shift in sectoral share in output and employment. If we talk about the table is based on the data of 2016 or close to it. Both the countries have experienced a noticeable structural transformation. Primary sector is no longer the principal contributor to GDP. The percentage share of primary sector in output and employment tended to decrease, while the percentage share in secondary and tertiary sectors tended to increase. For the economies of India and Pakistan, tertiary sector contributed more to GDP. Expansion of service sector in India and Pakistan is owing to the faster integration of these economies with the global economies. India and Pakistan experienced a major shift from primary to tertiary sector. Now let us talk about the demographic profile, and which is also to be understood through a table which is based on the survey of 2011. If you talk about this table, according to the survey 2011, the population of India was nearly 1210 million, which was nearly 18% of world's population, and the population of Pakistan was nearly 176.2 million, which is just 1/10 of India. The growth rate of population is very high in India. It is 1.76% and alarming high in Pakistan, 1.8%. At the existing rate of growth, population rate of India may soon exceed that in China. Pakistan has a very large geographical area than India, 382% per square kilometer in India, while 225% per square kilometer in Pakistan. Thus, Pakistan has low density of population compared with India. Pakistan has succeeded in providing better job opportunities outside agriculture than India. It shows a better sign of urbanization in Pakistan than India. If you talk about sex ratio is found 940 in India and 952 in Pakistan at per 1,000 of male. Low sex ratio shows social backwardness. Finally, it shows that population size of India is higher than that of Pakistan. Population growth rate of India is lower than that of Pakistan. Fertility rate of in India is lower than that of Pakistan. Sex ratio in Pakistan is higher than that of India. And urbanization in Pakistan is higher than that of India. Now, if we talk about the various indicators of human development, some of the followings are: one, life expectancy. Higher is always better. Added literacy rate, higher is always better. Percentage of population below poverty line, lower is always better. Means if we know about the percentage of people below poverty line, that this must be lower. Infant mortality rate, lower is better. Maternal mortality rate, lower is better. Percentage of population having access to improved water sources, higher is better. Percentage of undernourished population, lower is better. Percentage of population having access to improved sanitation, higher is better. Per capita GDP, higher is better. Thus, we can say a composite index based on these indicators is called Human Development Index. Higher HDI means Human Development Index rank shows higher level of growth and development of the country. HDI for India was estimated to be 0.647 and for Pakistan 0.560. So dear student, it was enough for today. I hope the video is clear to you all. We will understand the remaining part of the chapter in the next video. For today's class, it is enough. Thank you. Thank you for watching. Bye-bye.